Today we're talking with Paul Rennell. Paul captained Eastern Suburbs in the very first National League game in 1970. He is now our patron and a regular supporter at our Men's National League and Women's Winter Premier games. He is also a life member and could be described as a lifelong Lilywhite. I'm down here at Newmarket Park with patron Paul Rennell. I hear this is where the first ever National League game was played down here at Newmarket Park in 1970. Can you tell us a little bit about that game and who you guys came up against?
Yeah, Sunday the 11th of April 1970, we played our first National League game here at Newmarket Park against Hungaria from Wellington. We won 3-1. John Rothel, or JD as we call him, scored one of the goals in the 20th minute, and it was typical of JD. He drew the centre back, gave him a beautiful dummy, went forward and thumped the ball from outside the penalty area in the bottom right-hand side of the corner after 20 minutes. So it was the first goal of the National League era.
Paul, what happened with Hungaria? I heard they amalgamated with Wellington United.
That's right. They, in 1971, they amalgamated with Wellington United to form Wellington City in the 1971 competition.
Paul, what was the crowd like and the size of the crowd like here at Newmarket Park?
Well, to start off with, we had crowds of 2,000 to 3,000 at the first game, but they steadily grew over the season. And at the end of the season, we were playing before crowds of 9,000 to 10,000. And they used to just fill the actual concrete terraces, and it was a great atmosphere.
Can you tell us a little bit about JD, John Rothel? I hear he was quite the goal scorer and a bit of a crowd favourite. Can you tell us a little bit about him?
Yeah, John was a very good marksman. He knew where the goal was, and there was no mucking around. He used to tell us, "Give me the ball, I score the goals." So we had to do that. The first one that he scored, he was lethal and played off the last man. And his point power drives would scream past most keepers and leave the nets shaking. He was a great goal scorer.
Seems like we might need him in the team this season. Do you think he'd be up for a kick around this weekend?
He would if he was alive.
No. Paul, how many teams from the National League season in 1970 are still in the league today?
That is just us, Eastern Suburbs. The others, Blockhouse Bay, amalgamated with Bay Olympic, and Wellington, Mount Wellington joined with University. So we still are the only one in the competition from 1970, and we have never amalgamated.
That first season you played, 1970, let's go back. Do you remember where Eastern Suburbs finished in the league?
We finished equal on top with Blockhouse Bay, but unfortunately we lost out by goal difference, so we became runners-up.
So there were no playoffs back then like there are today?
No, nothing like that then, no.
Paul, do you have any specific memories from, you know, that first season back in 1970 that you'd like to tell us about?
Yeah, just being part of the whole affair was a great, great feeling. And after our games, because we had no club rooms or anything, we used to go to Romford's down on the waterfront in East Tamaki to have our match functions there. I was fortunate that I worked part-time for Rayburn Archie, who was a great supporter of the club, and he used to allow me to use the premises free of charge.
Well, thanks for your time, Paul. It's always good to get a bit of insight on, you know, where this league first began and how it's developed over time. Maybe we'll see you down back playing this weekend for the National League side. Maybe, you know, you can get out on the pitch again.
I'm a bit old, I think, now, Bonnie. But the following week when we play Hamilton, I'll be there.
Good to hear. Thanks for your time, Paul.
Thank you, Bonnie. Tarp.